Hi everyone, my name is Xiaoyu Wang. I'm the product manager for the TX Machine Platform. In a few tooltip Tuesday videos, I will demonstrate the various ways of using the material removal rate to optimize the tool grinding process by improving cycle time and reducing the wheel wear. The latest Sim3D software, the simulation engine, grind material progressively, calculating the MRR by subtracting the volume of the remaining workpiece from a previous move time. The MRR over time displays as a timeline chart, which gives precise MRR over the entire grinding process. Simply dragging the timeline cursor to any specific point, the MRR at the time is a readout on the right of the control panel. Now the math is done by the Sim3D, let's see how to use the MRR to improve the production efficiency and reduce cost in practice. Today, we will use a tapered barrel-shaped ball nose and mill as an example. Here are the list of the operations to grind this tool, and here is the simulation in Sim3D. Grinding wheels perform the best when used in the manufacturer's recommended MRR range. Higher than Qmax causes rapid wheel breakdown, while lower than Qmin can lead to wheel loading and wheels become dull. The wheel achieves a legendary self-sharpening state when grinding in the optimal range. For deep cut operations such as heavy fluting, the number of passes should be divided according to the MRR. In this example, we originally programmed the number of passes to be 1. Observing the material removal rate is higher than the recommended Qmax, we divide the number of passes to 3 and carefully choose the infeed. So now the material removal rate is more optimal. This will improve the wheel performance over time. Thanks for tuning in today's Tooltip Tuesday. Thank you.